Hey everyone, it's Patrick from Crumple Pop, and today I'm going to show you how to crossfade in GarageBand. So here I am in GarageBand, and I have two clips from an interview that I want to seamlessly transition between. Right now in the clip, there's a little bit of a blip noise at the cut, and I want to remove that. I'll play that for you.
And generous response. I told myself...
So you can hear that quick little blip. I want to remove that. The easiest way to do that is to create a crossfade. Fortunately, GarageBand doesn't offer a built-in crossfade tool like Logic or Pro Tools, but you can create your own pretty easily. So that's what we're going to do today. I'm going to line up these two clips for where I want the crossfade to happen. So you want it to be after he's done speaking and before the second clip starts speaking, and with some space in between so it sounds natural. You don't want it just lined up next to each other. So now that we have these two lined up, let's go up to the Mix menu and click Show Automation. You can also do that by pressing A on your keyboard. And we're going to create some automation points to make a fade out and a fade in. So first, we are going to go to our first clip, and when he stops speaking, create an automation point. And at the end of the clip, create a second automation point and drag that down to create a fade out. Next, we're going to go to the second clip. And as you can see, we already have an automation point at the beginning. So just make note of that. And we're going to create an automation point at the beginning of the clip and once he starts speaking. So we're going to want to bring this first point down to start from silence and then bring the second point down as well. So now we have a fade in. If these two are lined up correctly, this should sound smooth and seamless.
And generous response. I told myself the...
It sounds much better. The blip is removed. And that's how you create a crossfade in GarageBand.